The recipe was tried and true. Rick Rubin discovers a band, signs them to American, produces their album, and I punish the speakers in my 87 Camry. Hi, I'm Hurley, and this is What the Fuck Happened to God Lives Underwater. Underwater was formed in 1993 by David Reilly and Jeff Turzo. The group was discovered by Rick Rubin, who would later produce the albums that they released on American Records. Their self-titled EP and their debut full-length album, Empty, both were released in 1995. Songs from both albums made their way onto various soundtracks over the years, while the singles No More Love and All Wrong had moderate radio success. The formation of a new record label named 1200 Records was announced on June 28, 1997. God Lives Underwater had been signed even before the announcement had been made, moving on from Rick Rubin and American Records. 1200 Records changed their name to 1500 Records before releasing a few singles under the new name. Reilly and Turzo stayed busy under the new label. The duo produced remixes for a variety of artists, including Rob Zombie and Skinny Puppy, and they also organized the Depeche Mode tribute for the masses. It's good shit up there. In 1998, God Lives Underwater, along with producer Gary Dobbins, released the album Life in the So-Called Space Age. The single From Your Mouth reached number 17 on the Billboard's Modern Rock charts. The song was supported by a bizarre video of Hirofumi Nakajima eating in reverse. It was very weird. The single take pulled away from Hirofumi during the entire song, and to not bury the headline, the video was directed by Roman Coppola. Yeah, son of that famous Coppola. And I'll be back with more after this. For the next few years, God Lives Underwater hit the road with acts like Korn, Stabbing Westward, Filtered, Typo Negative, KMFDM, and the Deftones. But like many stories here on What the Fuck Happened, label turmoil was on the horizon. 1500 Records was purchased by Riffage.com in July of 2000, only to go bankrupt in December. With their label bankrupt, God Lives Underwater found themselves tangled in contractual obligations. The core members decided to part ways before their final album, Up Off the Floor, was released in 2004. While arguably their best work, the album was maligned for its poor sound quality, and justifiably so. Yeah, I played it for you. It's awful, isn't it? It's really bad. The album felt thin and was plagued with a tinginess that you would associate with an old MP3 you downloaded off of LimeWire. During our research, we couldn't determine exactly what happened to this album, but we have some theories. Perhaps the masters were lost when 1500 Records sold to Riffage.com and they only had scratch tracks to work with. Or maybe it was just the technology of the era. There was no Google Drive or Dropbox to share giant WAV and FLAC files. If you wanted to share something with somebody across the country, it had to be tiny or you had to snail mail that shit. These are just theories, but it's more plausible than an experienced group of musicians and producers simply just fucked this album up. But all is not lost. A high-quality version of 1% The Long Way Down was released on the 1500 Records sampler called Evolution. That version was mixed by Bob Clearmountain at Mix This Studios, and it is absolutely fantastic. Also available is their cover of David Bowie's legendary song Fame. Originally released for the film 15 Minutes, the song was supposed to be on their last album, but alas, that was not to be. Both the Evolution sampler and the 15 Minutes soundtrack can be found online for around $5. Take my money. After God Lives Underwater, Reilly worked on several projects, and in 2005 he was signed to Sony Music to release his first solo album, How Humans Are. Unfortunately, on October 16th of that same year, David Reilly passed away. The album How Humans Are was incomplete at the time of his death and was never released to the public. Jeff Turzo released new music in 2006 with his group Wired All Wrong. The debut album Breakout the Battle Tapes was met with mixed reception, with one reviewer saying, "The whole affair smacks of a cynical cash grab from a couple guys trying too hard to prove their relevance. Future fodder for the bargain bins." Well, this host would call that writer a mother... But if you're hoping for a bargain bin price on their CD, good luck. The album Breakout the Battle Tapes goes for about $15 on Amazon, and there's not a lot in circulation, so if you want one, I'd snap it up. The group never seemed to gain traction and disbanded in 2008. Unfortunately, this is where their story ends. There is no more material to release, and there is no plans to revive the project. While the impact God Lives Underwater had on music is up for debate, their impact on me as a person and a musician is not. Whether it was label turmoil or the crowded music scene at the time, God Lives Underwater never reached the notoriety that some of us believe they deserved. For fans of the band, however, they will always have a place in our personal pantheon of rock. Thanks for watching. Please hit like, hit subscribe if you're not a subscriber, and thank you to those of you who already are. If you enjoy our content, you're in a position to help the channel grow. Please join our Patreon at patreon.com/retromusicreview. Tell us in the comments what other Rick Rubin bands we should do. I could think of like 10. What was the first God Lives Underwater album you had? I picked up that EP in the used music section of a video department inside a grocery store. Off that album cover alone. Everybody was doing doll stuff on their album covers around that time. I do not know why.
Red 6-3.